only way we can hold the boggy lowlands around Falkirk is to build a castle and as many walls as we can construct in a short time. These fortifications will serve to protect our camp as we construct siege weapons with which to assault the English castle. Once the castle is constructed, Wallace himself has sworn to join our forces, and together we will attack Longshanks and his English troops.
Hey folks, it's Putz327, and welcome back to Age of Empires William Wallace tutorial campaign. We're on the last campaign mission of the... Well, it's tutorial levels, but still, it's the last one in the William Wallace campaign, and our objectives is to build a castle and destroy the English castle. So that's what we're gonna do. Okay, this scenario uses the Advanced Commands interface. Although you do not need to use the interface to play Age of Empires 2 HD Edition, it does provide access to some more powerful ways to control your civilization. Different civilizations have different strengths. For example, the Scots, who are represented by the Celtic or Celtic civilization, have powerful infantry. The Britons have low-range archers.
The English could attack at any time. You have some walls already, but you should complete them as soon as you have enough stone. Surplus resources of one type, you can sell them for gold at your market. You can then use the gold to buy what you need. Defend your city. Units can garrison within a tower for defense and protection, and archers can even fire out of a tower. You must first advance to the next age, the castle age.
Stop our walls.
The advance buttons let you set combat states for your soldiers. A defensive soldier will be less likely to attack an enemy that comes near him. Click a military unit, then note the combat stance buttons on the lower left corner of the screen. Using the advance buttons, you can also order a soldier to patrol an area between two points and guard or follow another unit. Enough resources to go to the castle age. You should do that soon. To a new type of formation. For example, with a box formation, you can protect a weak unit such as a monk.
Sorry, I'm not saying too much. I'm just trying to weigh my options on what I should do. We're about halfway to Castle Age, so that's good. And he blocked himself out. That's fantastic. Can I get back in? No. Okay.
Congratulations. You're going to find lots of things to do in the Castle Age. For starters, try building a siege workshop to make battering rams and other siege weapons.
Do that. But first we need to get our guy back inside, since he locked himself out.
You may need to assign extra villagers to gather stones so you'll have enough to build the castle and all the fortifications you'll need. Fire and excellent at knocking down walls. You may need some rams to attack the English castle.
Thank you. we get?
Ten of them to start, and we will put her on a farm.
Rob Wigan.
People.
kid. Oh.
Okay, Monk, you need to stay over here.
Great! You've completed the castle. Sir William should be here soon, and then attack the English.
Yeah, William Wallace coming to help us.
Wallace has come. One of your most powerful units is created at the castle. Create 10 more Woad Raiders. William Wallace and his Woad Raiders on your side. The English may be in trouble. Once you have a large army with plenty of siege weapons, go. Destroy the English castle. Trebuchets are massive siege weapons with a great range, available only in the Imperial Age. Remember, the trebuchets must be packed to move and unpacked to fight.
Kid, bar Afnunga.
Thank you.
Yes.
Pull.
Stone.
Castle at Falkirk is no more. The English pretensions in Scotland are surely at an end. The forces of Wallace are triumphant.
Victorious. All right. So yeah, they didn't have much at all over here. They kept sending their people. What's over here? One yellow guy. Okay, so, yeah, we did all that, and now we quit card game, yes.
It looked certain that we would be defeated at Falkirk, yet Somehow, though outnumbered and outranged by English longbows, we were victorious! English castle was torn down, and a Scottish one will be built in its place. William Wallace has shown us the path to victory. Although he's but one man, he inspires great deeds in others, and many of the Scottish princes and lords have drawn their swords with his. Wallace's own sword is a 5.5-foot beast, forged, of course, in Scotland. He has sworn not to rest until his sword finds the neck of Edward Longshanks. The struggle will continue, but we have learned the ways of war. Now, it is the English who will know fear.
All right, well, that is the end of the William Wallace learning campaign, so I'm going to cut this episode here, and in the next episode we will be going on to Joan of Arc. It's a little more difficult, but we'll get through it. We also have plenty other campaigns to go to. We have Barbarossa, Genghis Khan, Saladin, and then we also have... the Conquerors, the Forgotten, the African Kingdoms, and the Rise of the... I want to say Rajas, but for some reason I think that might be wrong. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please remember to like, share, comment, subscribe. Visit me on... I forgot what it was. Twitch. I'm going to be doing some streams and... may even be doing some streams of this game here pretty soon. And if you'd like to help the channel in a more direct way, please visit me on Patreon. Again, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, see ya!